chance for adventure. What's your poison? What's your pleasure? Oh.
This is a unique beat, isn't it? Put this over here. This is a unique beat. How's everybody doing tonight? How's everybody doing? This is the audio a little high. Audio's a little high. We'll turn it down a little bit. Rex, what's going on? Surreals, Hammerhead, Someone, Daniel, PNM, Kasari, Shadow Demon, Isaac, False Knight, Sam, how you guys doing? How you guys doing? Don't call me. Don't start that again. Come on now. Come on now. Do I look like a gym? Does this face look like a gym? Is this a gym face? Alright, so here's the deal. Pro Indie Dev starts in 3 hours. We have 24 games to get through already. We're going to try our best to get through 24 games in 3 hours so that after we're done, we can all go watch Pro Indie Dev. I really don't want to miss that. And I really don't want you guys to miss that because there's so much good stuff there. So if there's leftover games, we may have to push them till next week. I'm hoping we won't have to. I'm going to try my best to kind of spend the same amount of time on every game. I know I have a bad habit of like going off on tangents and getting lost for a half hour in a game or something like that. But I'm going to try and like keep the feedback specific, be specific, and play a good 5 minutes of it. And we'll do it. Sam, what's up? First time watching the stream? Well, welcome, dude. So we're going to get right into it. So first up, we got a game called Riskless Alpha by Rex T. Gunn. He was cool enough to put this in 18 million folders for me. Thank you, Rex. I appreciate it. Adam, dude, we're going to try and get through all the games. I don't know if I have time to do that stuff because we only have like 3 hours to do it. So we gotta move quick. But, all right, let's play Riskless Alpha. Okay, you better not give me a... Is this an installer, Rex? Rex, my rules say no installers. Rex, you put it in 18 million folders and then you give me an installer, man. Rex, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? Thank you for taking your time to do such stuff. Comtar, thank you so much. I appreciate it, man. Thank you for the $5. It's all good. I'm happy to do this stuff. Okay. Rex. Man. You're lucky. You're lucky that you're a good member of the community, and I've seen you around, and I've seen you interact with the community, I've seen you talk. Cause if I didn't know you were a big part of the community, if I hadn't seen you interacting the last couple days, I'd be like, nope, I can't do it. But thank you for being a part of the community. I'm gonna do this because we got to get through it. This better not be the game. If this is the game, no, I don't want to play any installer games. It's Tim Rage, the game is off to a good start. No, that should not be your guys' objective on Feedback Friday. Objective is not to make Tim rage. All right, we're trying to give feedback on games here. So feedback number one: please follow instructions. When someone says no installers, no exceptions, please don't give them an installer. That's my first piece of feedback, Rex. Let's move on and play the game. We could do this. We could do it. This better not be a rage game, man. P- players have little patience for installers as well. I mean, it makes sense sometimes, but definitely not in a game jam. No exceptions except when exceptions are made. Yeah, unfortunately I'm too nice. Maybe I gotta be stricter. Okay, what did I do? Oops. Okay. Press enter. Okay. Press enter again. Oh fucking shit fuck. No. I'm bleeding badly. I should have read the instructions. I know you sent me instructions. Hold on. I think it was J and K or something. Yes. Fucked them up. I like the soundtrack. Eat it. Eat it. Oh, I'm dead. Alright. Okay, one thing I'll say on this is, like, the soundtrack is so cool. It almost feels weird that it continues. Like, I feel like it should stop and give me some, like... give me some, I don't know, like, you fucked up music. Because this is, like, cool to play at, right? But when I die, I want it to be like, yo, you fucked up. Can you guys hear the sound? Alright. There's sounds. You hear the sounds? How do I keep dying? Is it like two hits? Oh my god, I keep dying. Okay. What does K do? Oh, I could. Oh, fuck with me now. Yeah. Yeah. Teleportation. That feels great. I can't even catch me. Swoop in, teleport out. Nope, not gonna get surrounded, nope. Is that a boss? How long does this game take you, man? This is sweet. This feels cool. You told me how long it took you. I'm just gonna fill it out. Alright, I will say, it's a harder enemy, so enemies just keep getting harder. So I know you sent me the instructions in the notepad, but for players, I really feel like that should be in the game. And because this game is like so simple, I think you could actually even put it on the screen here. Although that might take away from the super clean aesthetic. Really like the soundtrack. I like the blood. I like the bleeding. How I'm dripping blood, or how he drips blood. I really like the teleport. Although I feel like that should have some cooldown, because it feels like it's just too good. Train jam. I've always wanted to do the train jam. That's like on my bucket list. I've always wanted to do that. I'm fortunately not going to make either one of those this year, but I've always wanted to do that. Been practicing making blood juicier and juicier. Teleport is kind of OP. That's what I would say, because like I could just get out of anywhere. It's so awesome and it's so cool, but I feel like I just feel like it's too good. I'd get out of anywhere. I really like how it looks. I like the AI. They're not like super, they don't just run towards you. I don't actually know how I'm dying though. Is there another level? How do I get to the other? Oh, there's more levels. Let's try that. Oh shit. That's the playing like a little bitch. And just teleporting out of there. Swoop in, hit him, teleport. Use your shield. Oh, he can't hit me when I have a shield on? Doesn't do any damage, so I just block and then that's interesting. All right, so I'm having a really hard time figuring out. I mean, I guess the game's just that quick. It's so quick I'm missing it. Because there's like a fade when I get hit. And I really like the blood. I like this, dude. Rex, is there some specific feedback you wanted? Your stamina will lower? Where's my stamina at? Yeah, if there's stamina, I would say teleport should probably have something to do with that too. Oh, the ring is your stamina? Oh, okay. I did not notice that. So, is that in the other level? It is. I didn't notice that at all. I completely 100% did not notice that at all. So maybe that's something to take into consideration. Like, as a player, I didn't even notice that. It's a cool game though, dude. I really like it. I really like the soundtrack. I really like the art. I really like how it's put together. Where can I download the game? Rex, do you want me to share the link or not really? How's everybody doing tonight? We got a bunch of people here, a bunch of new people. Game Loop Games, thank you for the follow, by the way. I missed that the first time. Maybe make it more obvious when the enemy's about to attack. Well, it's a really quick game, so the lead up, I don't know if that would fit, but I have closed tests on my server. Okay, so we won't share the link. But it's a cool game, dude. Is there any specific questions you have for me? Cthulhu Critic, thank you for the subscription on YouTube. Appreciate it. Your art is like Hyper Lake Drifter in the best possible way. Yeah, it's cool. The art and the soundtrack go really well together. Falling Word. Okay, we gotta get our mobile stuff set up. Alright, this is a mobile game. I'm gonna install it. This game's called Falling Word.
Thanks for all of your videos.
Hammerhead. Thank you for the 10 bucks, man. I appreciate it. Thank you for doing that. No problem. I'm happy to help. I actually have a lot of fun playing you guys' games. It lets me kind of broaden my understanding of games as well as, like, just see patterns in stuff and how people create stuff, and it's actually helpful for game development. I think developers probably should watch stuff like this too, because if you guys have been watching stuff, like, you'll see the common problems come up a lot. A lot of the same problems happen over and over again. Mob is in. Tim, is this event after Feedback Friday Live or already recorded? It's live and it starts at 10 p.m. EST. So I'm gonna host Starlight after this, and we're gonna watch it together. So hopefully we're gonna kind of try and breeze through this if we can. Not like, you know, just spend no time on everybody's games, but I'm trying to spend the same amount on everybody's games, because sometimes I spend a disproportionate amount. Sometimes I'll play a game for a half hour or something. I never got to see the game properly, so I can't comment on the enemy lead up to attacks, but Hyperlight Drifter makes a great effort to clearly show pre-attack stance. That might be something worth playing around with. I'll tell you, as a player, I felt a little bit frustrated because I didn't know I was getting hit and I didn't know why I was dying. Tim, are you going monthly with these after this or not yet? I don't know. I haven't made that decision yet. Because we're getting more and more every single week. Like this week we had 24 games before I even started. That's a record. So I definitely don't want to, like, because, like, if we do it monthly at this point, there'll be, like, 60, 80 games. But I don't know. I got to figure out how to do this sustainably, to be honest. Like, all right. So let's play it. I got to figure out a way to do it sustainably and where it works for me and it works for you guys. All right. So this is Falling Word. Hopefully this might be a little small on YouTube. But hopefully you guys can see me play it. I need to get the pro version of this, actually. How much is it? Oh, I'll do that later. It's gonna mess with the gameplay. The pro version, you can maximize this, so I'm probably gonna do that. Alright, let's play. How to play. Every level has a specific subject that all words are related to. Just swipe to crush the words. Oh god, I suck at these kind of games. If you can't connect the letters, you can tap undo or reset. If you want to help, to tap ask a friend to share letters or find words that are not part of the solution. When you find a bunch of them, you learn. That's it. Enjoy the game. Let's start. Bear. Aw, yes. I spelled bear wrong the first time. Well done. Okay. Is this, it's a capital city. I don't fucking know. Burn. I was just guessing. I got it. Alex, I got that. Nation, Iraq, gold, got that. Animal, deer. That took me too long. That took me too long. Solo. I guess the hidden word. I get 25 coins. What the fuck is a capital city? Oslo, okay. I got it. I had to do solo, okay? That's a thing. A nation? This is okay, this game, it's gonna make you guys are gonna you get like a snapshot into my brain, like how I think. Which I hope it just keeps to simple four letter words. I don't even know. Oh, yes I do. Wow, I thought I tried that. No, that doesn't count. That doesn't count, okay? I thought I tried that. Somebody could be named Riso, okay? You don't know them? You don't know what they eat for breakfast? Okay? Don't judge them. We don't judge here. I really wish Nicole was here right now. Rose, okay. Wait, I'm gonna try that. God damn it. Okay. I did it. Thank you, Sam. I appreciate you. I really wish Nicole was here right now because she loves these kind of games. She could help me out. All right. I'm probably the worst person to give feedback on this game, to be honest, because this is not my type of game. I'd like to know your opinion about the game in general and about the levels of difficulty. The game's cool. The game looks great. The game sounds great. Navy, my chat's just solving it for me at this point because I'm... I know this one, guys. I didn't go through. I got that one right, okay? I got that one right. More. Wait. Rome. More should have been a hidden word. I should have got extra gold for that. Pure, that should have been a hidden word. My advice for this game would be have better audio, make it more satisfying to win. Does it have more than four letters later on? Peru. Yeah, I know Peru. Does this count as a multiplayer game? This would be fun as multiplayer, right? This would be great. Yeah, so I'm not good at this game. Oh, Aros, you fucked me up, man. You fucked me up. Jay, thank you. No, it's got a ton of polish. I agree with, like, the windscreen. It doesn't feel, like, winny and congratulations enough, like, especially for these type of mobile games. These mobile games are, like, really high on the polish with sound, so I feel like yay, or like just like a grunt birthday party kind of sound would be great for this, or any kind of just like da-da-dun, like some kind of positive reinforcement sound. I also, and this again, I don't play these type of games, so take this feedback however you will. This screen, I don't feel like needs to, like, I feel like it should keep the person going. So, like, I feel like maybe, Drew, well done, boom, 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 3 stars, and then it goes to the next one. So, like, because I actually feel like I want to keep going. And then there's the ad, okay. Peru, Cuba, those are countries, not nations. Were they under nations? That's probably something to take into account as well. But it visually looks good. I think it needs some audio work. So I would work on the audio, but visually you got it unlocked, dude. So I don't have anything to to saying that. Is the developer in chat? If so, let me know if you have any specific questions. Starfire, what's up, man? I'm doing good. How are you? Gary. Gary. If you guys want to play this game, it's available now on Android. You can do so here. Boom. That was a nice game. Yeah, it looked nice. It looks cool. All right, number three, Adam. So we're going to play Spike Blade. Oh, you didn't give me a link. You said you uploaded my game in beta Google Play, so I need your Gmail so I can add you as a beta tester. Tim@gamedevunderground.com. So we're going to skip you for now. If you're in the chat and you want to add me as a beta tester, I'll get an email and I'll follow it up. But for now, we're going to skip that game. How did the ads work in this game? They showed up after a couple playthroughs, probably 10, I would say. All right, so we're going to skip Spike Blade. Asteroid Belt Miner. This sounds familiar. You have to do it next week. All right, man. We will do it next week. If we do a Feedback Friday next week. All right, so this is a purchase. I assume we're going to play the demo. Are these only installers? Guys, there are instructions for a reason. All right, I'm serious. Starting next week, if someone sends me an installer, I'm gonna have to skip you. I'm serious. Next week, it's gonna say no exceptions, and seriously, no exceptions, because I gotta stop making exceptions. It's making me look like a dumbass. Just follow the instructions, peeps. I'm too nice. That's my problem. I'm too nice. I'm way too nice. All right. In the year 2054, humanity has started colonizing the solar system. Besides scientific research, a new era of resources mining had started. Asteroid Belt is found to be particularly rich in minerals and was accessible to mining equipment. Most asteroids are hollow inside, containing many caves. A remote-controlled mining drone can be teleported inside and used to navigate the caves to find and mine resources. However, large corporations are planning to monopolize the mining industry. To that end, they have planted traps and defense mechanisms inside most of the asteroids in order to deter small independent entrepreneurs. They've also taken control of financial institutions, changed the repayment plans, and threatened small mining businesses with foreclosure. This is a lot of reading, dude. It's a lot of reading up front. Just saying, a lot of reading. I know all this fiction is important to you, but like, I feel like I have enough fiction already to start the game. Family, friends are now in danger of losing their possessions, mortgage for the small business. Lenders demanding a final payment of 500,000 universal credits, which would pay off the business failure. See, I feel like you could do this, you could say everything you said in like three lines. You must act quickly to get the required 500,000. Like, you gave me the objective and all that, you set up the backstory, but I feel like you could just do it quicker. In paper, please, there are pretty pictures. Yeah, you can make it more visual too, like if you got a lot of stuff, but also like, learning how to take a paragraph and put it into a sentence, I think, is a really valuable skill. It's not always easy, but You know, I think it's important. It's something that I learned in marketing for sure, because I used to want to write paragraphs. You need a virtual machine, Tim? Yes, I do. Yes, I do. There's a lot of stuff I got to figure out. All right, this window shows the hints available for the current level. Can be set up, show automatically at the start of the level. Like this could be one sentence. Doesn't have to be two paragraphs. You see what I'm saying? Especially, it looks like this is a mobile game. Nobody's going to read this shit on mobile. PC players don't read. Mobile players read less than reading. All right. Drone is teleported inside. Move the drone on top of a resource patch. Teleporter pad. Okay, I had to click it again. I make optional lore that you can read about. Yeah, some people like to get into all that and they like to read about it. Some people just want to play the game. Tim also doesn't read. I don't. I really don't. But most players don't read. I'm not gonna read that. Oh, is that, wait, is this, okay, these are the resources. This thing was blinking at me, I thought that's where it wanted me to go. All right, one thing I will say is, like, it was really weird for me. When I go on the teleporter and it doesn't teleport me, that was really weird. So, I don't know why I have to do an extra click. Like, it just seems like that click is unnecessary. Does that make sense? I think more time should be dedicated to explaining the mechanics and the story. I think straight up people need to be able to like to play the game. If they got to go through a bunch of screens and stuff, it's gonna be rough. Okay, Adam wants, or I'm sorry, QBQ Games wants feedback on everything you can. Randomized procedural generation work with this game. Also web presentation. I think procedural generation works really well with this game. Like these guys. I can tell they're bad. Like, the only way that you could make them look more bad is by making them, like, red or something, and that's not even necessary. So, that whole screen, I'm not really sure is necessary in this type of game. Okay, I gotta put down a bomb. Well, I can't put a bomb there, can I? Oh shit. Uh, I like the explosion. Yeah. I feel like the sound effects feel a little off, though. Like, just being completely honest, I feel like they don't quite fit the coolness of the sci-fi world. I feel like AeroWSD would work well with this game. Yeah, I think it's a mobile game. I think that's why they did click. Based on just the menu. So we mined 3 out of 30 asteroids. We can buy. Is this the sell button? Plus or whatever that is. So I'm not 100% clear what this menu does. So I feel like this needs a little bit of clarification. I'm assuming this is buy and sell. Maybe, but that's a weird icon. I don't know. What else can we do? We can buy equipment. So this, okay, plus and minus, I get. The other icon I didn't quite get. I always feel like the sound should match the visuals to immerse the player more. Yeah, I don't. These sounds, like, they kind of break me from the immersion, if that makes sense. Because the visuals look really good and the stuff is cool, but the sounds feel cheap compared to what the game is. Let's buy some mines. What is this? Stats. Let's play one more time. In the menu, you pick many, how many materials you sell, and the arrow icon means all. Did you get that box at first glance? Maybe I just don't play these types of games. Sounds kind of a late 90s freeware game sound to them. Okay. And also, like, that stuff keeps coming up too. Fuck! When I click on him the first time, it should not spawn a mine. That's... And now I'm dead. I'm just dead. This, since this is the core loop of the game too, and that animation was cool the first time, I feel like it kind of gets in the way now. Especially if this is going to be the core loop. You get this stuff, you go back, you get more stuff, you go back. It seems to take too long now when I'm just going to go in. Because this is basically like a clicker game, right? Like, you just go and you collect resources. How do I get gold? Do I have to click on it when I get there? Or blow up while I was trying? Yeah, like this, I would just want to retry. I have to watch it over and over again. Also, like, what does the game do if I don't have the bombs? If I don't have the right bombs. Okay, so sometimes it takes me to the next asteroid. Sometimes it doesn't. I don't understand why. I guess if I'm still alive, is that, and then when I die, I have to go back? Is that what that's for? Okay, so I think this game looks great. I think it needs a little bit of audio. tweaking, maybe. I think it needs some usability testing. And I think the text needs to be reduced in the front. That's just my basic thoughts. The page, I think, suffers from the same problem. This is a lot of text. I would put... I don't think that these are the features of your game. The resolution and the touchscreen. I think you need to go into mining combat, mine resources for space, defend against the galaxy, stuff like that. I would do fantasy first. So I would have like actual world features of the gameplay, not just like usability features. And I would put those up top. And then in addition, this main graphic, I feel like, needs to have the name of the game so that I know. And this doesn't really catch, like, this part catches my eye, but this part, I don't know. I guess I just don't like how this is laid out. I would test different images, but I would have like a title image. Like, even like this image right here would be great, dude, or something like this. And that shows a little bit of gameplay. We got a video here. Let's look at the promo. That's not even enough time to read any of that. It's too much, dude. I can't even read that. And I don't feel like the music fits this at all. I feel like this should be more like hardcore. I don't think this music fits this trailer at all, dude. Yeah, it's... How long is it, too? I feel like it should be less than a minute. And all of these gameplay sessions can be shorter. Like, you don't need to show this much. You could just show, like, him avoiding the enemy once. And this part, you could just show the blowing up part. I can recognize that royalty free music. This trailer's way too long too, dude. I feel like it should be less than a minute. You need some more sci-fi-ish music. The music does not fit here at all. And each one of these little segments need to be shorter. It feels like it drags on a lot. And if you're watching this, if the developers in the chat or anything, I don't mean to be mean, dude. I'm not trying to like rag on your shit. I'm legit trying to help, because like I'm just saying, like, I did marketing for a number of years, and this stuff is really important. This title image and this trailer is gonna determine whether or not people play your game 100%. So this stuff you need to take 100% serious. Timbo or Jim, thanks guys. Gameplay trailers usually have everything faster at speed, like 2x. You can also get away with, like, if look on my main, on this is my main website for Phalophobia. Look how long I show gameplay for each section. It's literally like a second or two. But it's long enough to tell what's going on. And you can like kind of see the main action-y point of the game. And because the cuts are so quick, it makes it seem really action-y and fun. And if this same approach was taken into a trailer with some really cool music over it, I think it'd be really good. Like this just seems really, really slow. And because of the music choice, it just feels weird. So I feel like you need faster paced music, you need more sci-fi music, and you need quicker cuts on the action scenes. Not to say you should make it look like an action game. It's not an action game, right? So you want to show what the game is, but it just... I first of all, I think you can cut it down to like 1 minute instead of 2 minutes. and just really like focus on the core parts of the game. I always wondered why you call it Game Dev Underground, said Tim Ruswick. After all, it's about you. How is it about me, dude? This is about this community. This is where we hang out. Because who doesn't want to be part of the underground? I know, right? Underground's badass. All right, we're going to move on. Thank you for submitting this game. If you guys want to check this game out... Oops. What did I do? You can check out Asteroid Belt Miner. Here we go. On Twitch. And on the YouTubes. What does it mean, one part of the cult? There is no cult. Alexander, your game is next. Games in a Box 3D. Let's play it. All right. How do you get a game played for Feedback Friday? You join our Discord and you wait till next week and you can submit early. I released the link on Thursdays ahead of time. I look like an old high school friend of mine named Steven, so you look more like a Steve than a Tim or Jim. I look like a Steve? Really? I look like a Steve? All right. Here we go. Is the game list available somewhere? No, it's in a forum that I only have access to. Probably wouldn't be a bad idea to make the game list available. Some people submit links that they don't want public, though. Alright, what kind of feedback did you want on this? Sorry if localization is bad for my English. Are there any prospects for the project? What do you think in general? I spent 150 in ad reads the last 3 months and got 3,500 installs, 2,700 uninstalls. Returned to only $10 for an in-app ads. I show skippable ads every 5 minutes and non-skippable ads every 10. Do I need to publish each game separately and get more installs? Okay, so let's play. So, okay, so this is a bunch of different games then. You can always submit a virus to see everything on Tim's PC. Thanks, Oros. Thanks for giving everybody ideas. Appreciate you. Tim is many things to many people, but he's Steve to nobody. Alright, we're gonna play Classic. Turn over tiles and try to find the match with fewer turns. Okay. Alright, so... What? Okay, I didn't know I was memorizing stuff. Stuff looks so similar. Infect the phone. Yeah, I need a virtual device for my computer, and I need a separate device for the phone. I know. Thank you. All right, so as far as I know, this he doesn't want feedback on the game. He wants feedback on the monetization. Okay, I'm probably not the best guy to ask that, to be honest. Like I did a little bit of consulting and marketing for getting user bases in my marketing company, but I never ever actually worked on the internals of the monetization. So anything that I would have to say is like stuff that I've heard people talk about, or like stuff that I don't have direct experience on. So I don't think I could really help you there, dude. 8 + 7, 9 + 8. I can't math. Why the 3D part in the title? I don't know. 8 + 7. I think these games are cool, dude. Yeah, I can't give you much on as far as microtransactions goes. The games look good. It's cool that there's a lot of different games. Jackson, what's up? How can I monetize? Forget about this project and just completely move forward. Yeah, so maybe the title is part of the problem. Because a lot of people in chat are saying, one, it doesn't need to have 3D, but also I wouldn't necessarily install something that said games in a box. And it's called Ginab Logic and Puzzle Click. It's good that you have a subtitle here. That's really good. Seems like people rate it highly. You know, another way that you could do this too is maybe you'd have to look at your analytics, man. Like, If people play a certain type of game, maybe that certain type of game should be its own game. Or two, if they play long in a certain game, maybe you could have in-app purchases to unlock more levels in that game or something like that. You just have to try stuff. I don't think you should give up, because I think this is really cool what you've got here, and it seems like you're adding even more games. But I don't think AdWords is smart. I don't think AdWords is a good idea. You don't have the monetization down. You don't know that you're going to make money. So unless you're really testing and you just did that for data, I don't think spending ads is a good idea. I would approach some publishers, some mobile publishers. I don't know of any publishers that publish stuff like this, but a lot of them have monetization guys in-house that can help you with this kind of stuff. Pay to unlock more games, that's always an idea too. Yeah, so yeah, I'm sorry I can't give you more insight in that. I don't have a whole lot of experience. None of my mobile games are monetized, so it wouldn't make sense for me to give you monetization advice. Here's the link for the game if you guys wanna play it. Alright, moving on. Okay, we got a Steam key. All right, while that's downloading, we're going to go on to the next one. All right, here's another Google Play app. All right, Quibble Cat. I say give a good amount of starting games with have additional games you could buy for really cheap, 50 cents for a dollar. I think the minimum is a dollar in-app purchase. I could be wrong about that. Last time I checked, I think it was. Maybe that was the minimum premium. Because I think people would totally do like 10 cent shits if that was the minimum. In-app currency to unlock games, that's not a bad idea. Or else, I get it, dude. I get it. I know. I gotta get on that shit. Just like I gotta get HTTPS on Game Dev Underground. Oh, fuck. I got a lot of shit I gotta do, man. Really, I need like a fucking assistant at this point. Because just the content alone is like keeping all the stuff in chat, keeping all the email stuff, keeping all the video stuff, working on all the analytics, proving stuff, the websites, all the stuff I'm working on writing, and all the elite stuff on top of that. I'm really behind on all that. All right, we're going to play this. Here we go. Access my contacts. What the fuck? God damn it. Yes, I need a separate device. Did you play Metal Gear Survive? I played the beta. You gotta have Zoro become a YouTube star? Let's do it. Alright, we're gonna pet the kitty. You hear the kitty purr? I wish getting views was this easy, man. You know how much I work for my views? I pet the kitty. Looks all fancy. The ads, man. What? Are you kidding me? What? Dude, there's way too many ads in this game. There's an ad up top, two popped up randomly. And there's...
Life without money is pretty boring.
Wait, what is happening? Yo, like... And then... Oh my god, dude. Is this button... Does it play an ad? Is that what...
Start your business adventure with Cash okay. Inc. Start
Holy
with one
shit.
Business.
Okay, and it doesn't even hit me. Let me hit the X. It loads the demo game every time. Hold on. Okay. I think I pressed that button and an ad shows up. So, I don't think it's their fault. Just for full disclosure, I don't think it's his fault. I think his button actually brings up an ad. But that's not very clear. Okay, maybe not. More Jesus. Okay. There's too many ads, dude. It's just too much. It's too much. What did you want feedback on? You want what can be improved? How can it be more engaging? This game is based on a famous YouTuber. I need some marketing strategies to get this game in front of his audience. I tried emailing him, tweeting him, but I see no response. I contacted about 50 YouTubers to record gameplay and put it on their channels, but I get response from only two of them, which have around 150 subs. I did some ASL on the game too. Is there any way of paid marketing with low budget? Then what could be best? You need to focus on the game first, dude. I need to see, like, how many installs does this have? 10 to 50? It would be more engaging if you could actually play the game. I mean, yo, like, okay, I don't want to be mean. Like, obviously, I don't play this type of game at all. So my feedback is not relevant in a lot of ways. But I would just say, like, this game frustrated the shit out of me with the ads. Okay, I don't know if you could tell by my face and my body language, but, like, holy shit, man. The ads. So again, I'm not the target audience. I probably wouldn't be playing a clicker game anyway. So also, like, these menus right here, they seem to block the actual clicking. Like, I have to click this and then exit to continue doing the game. Like, now I'm tapping the kitty and I'm not. Wait, do I have to tap her in certain spots? So I can't even get the views anymore by tapping. So I would say you've got to focus on getting a good game before you shove monetization down throats like that. You have to seriously. This game has to be fun and engaging before you do that. If you can make a fun and engaging game, even if it's free, even if you don't make money, you can start building your download base. And once you have a good download base, then you can introduce monetization. Adding stuff like that is making it less engaging. Like, you're actually pushing people away. The only people you're not pushing away is little kids who have no idea what they're doing anyway. And your monetization strategy should not be to manipulate kids into tapping on ads. So the main thing I would say is focus on the game, man. And I don't really have any actual improvements on the game because I don't really play this type of game. And as far as contacting the YouTuber, like, if someone made a game about me like this, there is no way in hell I would promote it. And I'm just being completely honest. I'm not trying to down anybody. I'm not trying to be mean. I'm just telling you exactly how I feel. Because this game feels predatory. So, like, if I thought it was, like, a funny game, you know, or something, maybe that would be worth it, but it's just... It's not. I'm not feeling it. So, I don't have any actual constructive feedback, like, actual things that you should change. I'm sorry about that. I don't generally play this type of game. But I think it's something that you're going to have to kind of work and iterate on. And I think you're pushing people away. I think you're actually artificially lowering the engagement by popping stuff up at people. So, okay. Yeah, I hate to talk bad, especially like, you know, people are part of our community. They worked hard on something and they made something. So I hate to talk negatively about it, no matter what it is, but sometimes I have to say the things that I feel. You probably won't review RPGs. I have to be able to play the games in like 5 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes. So RPGs probably are not the best fit for Feedback Fridays. It's not really what Feedback Fridays are for. Also want to know why it needs your contact list. Yeah, it's fucking... YouTubers love funny games. One guy in Discord made a really funny game. End of the world, and now YouTubers, millions of subscribers are playing it. Yeah. Absolutely. Tim plays any games, I think RPGs include. Yeah, I'll play any game, but you have to be... I have to play it, you know, in a short period of time. So I don't think it would do justice to your game, basically, is what I'm saying. All right, so we're downloading Car Chase Simulator by Oh You Touch My Tralla. Second meter is a hit. Yeah, big shout out to Avocavo, man. Good fucking job on that shit. He got played by Jacksepticeye. It was all over the Game Dev Underground chat. I posted it in our Elite, but also I think it got, I don't know, how many views does it have now? It's here somewhere. Maybe it was way back. I don't know. But good fucking job, man. Car Chase Simulator. Shame the game is free completely. Avocado should learn a lot of money on that. He should, man. That was one of my favorite games that I played, and I told him that. Like, it's... The game was really good. Like, I get why it was free, because it was his first game, and he wanted to push it out there and just get experience doing all that. And it was pretty short, right? Like, it's 60 seconds with, like, 10 or so endings or something. But, yeah, dude, he fucking deserves it. He deserves doing well. I hope his next game does really well. Which game are you talking about? Meteor 60 Seconds. Lentor, what's up, man? All right, let's play Mission 1. This reminds me of, like, GTA already. Oh, you gave me the right car. You gave me the right car. Oh, you gave me. Oh no. That's a shame to do that to this car. I'm really bad at driving this thing. Holy shit. These things are not that hard to drive in real life. They break traction easier than anything, but they're not that hard to... I'm not gonna be going that quick. No, sir. Not stopping. God damn these. Oh shit. Fuck off. My car's getting fucked. I don't feel like there's a way to recover from the oversteer and the understeer all that much. Alright, I gotta go this way. Oh shit. Okay, how do I feel like the game's still going? Do I click? That one is fun to watch. It was fun to play, man. I don't know how to... Let me see what he wanted feedback on. He says, harsh enough to make me commit suicide. Wow, okay. I'm not that harsh, man. I'm not that harsh. I will say this is probably a bug, but I don't know how to get back to the menu. So, I'm gonna close it. I'm gonna play that again real quick because I was quick. I clicked okay multiple times. It didn't work. It didn't work. I don't know. Let's up the resolution to. Maybe that'll help. Man, I miss my Challenger. I had a Challenger for a couple years. I was a fucking beast. I had a Camaro too. I love that Camaro. Oh, here they come for a chance, for adventure. What's your poison? What's your pleasure? Oh, he sent me a Dropbox link, so I'm not going to share it. Because it's specific. But, all right, we're going to play Artifact Dive by Jason Kennedy. I don't think YouTube mutes part of your videos. The entire stream is going to get muted or taken down. Yeah, no, it they'll tell me now. They used to mute everything, but now they tell you this section has copyrighted music and you can mute that specific section. They have a thing where you can remove the music and replace it, but it doesn't work very well. So it usually just has to mute that whole section. And I've had to do that on a couple of my videos, unfortunately, because I played music. Like when we did Ludum Dare and we were going through all the different music to find one to buy, some of that music was actually copyrighted and I had to mute that section. Unfortunately. I don't know if that's just a feature for more than 10,000 subscribers, though. Because I remember back in the day on YouTube, they would mute the whole thing. So I don't know if they change it for everybody or if... I know you get certain perks when you reach 1,000 subscribers and 10,000 subscribers. And something to do with music or something was there, I remember. It's been a Twitch thing. Yeah, Twitch does that too. Okay, what did you want feedback on? How does the gameplay loop feel? Too fast, too slow? Your job is to find the artifact and get out before running out of power. Your gun and deflector both use energy. WC to move, aim mouse, fire is left mouse button, escape pause. Okay. Okay, so this is kind of Binding of Isaac type game. If I'm understanding this right. Sometimes, maybe it's just because of the, yeah, I think the window's covering the bottom part of it. I can't see. Let me start this game. At 1920. Oh, it won't let me. Let's go this size then, so we can fit the whole thing. Alright, so it looks like it is procedural because it's different. That's cool. In these type of games, a map is always helpful, but I know maps are kind of complex to create. In this type of game. So you just kind of got to survive in this game. Die. Do I gotta find the boss room or just survive? Because I have a key. Oh, there we go. I assume that's the door.
Alright, you got the artifact. Time to get out.
Alright, now we gotta get out. But we killed everything. Oh, we did it! We did it! We did it. Okay, LD39. How does the gameplay feel? Too fast, too slow, too simple, too complex? I think your game is good. I feel like the combat could have been better. I feel like there could have been more enemies or better shooting or maybe power-ups. This is a little, you made this in 2 days, so I'm not saying you should have had that already, but I'm saying if you wanted to take it further. These types of games are fun because of their items and their enemies. So without like a good selection of items and enemies, I feel like this game maybe falls short in some ways. But I really like it. I like the premise of it. Also, finding your way back, I got lucky. I think finding your way back in procedural games like this might be really difficult without a map. So I would look into that. There's no sense, especially if they killed everything. Sometimes there's no sense of just going all the way back. Like maybe there could be a ladder out of the cave or whatever it is. I just feel like that part might be a little unnecessary. Other than that, it's a good game, dude. Gameplay feels solid. Like I said, the combat could feel better. The bullets, for example, could actually add the vector of the player, which is what Binding of Isaac does. However you're moving or wherever you're moving, it adds that to the bullet in addition to the bullet speed. So if you're running towards something, your bullets go out faster than you. They don't just stay with you. I don't think this game did that. That might be worth adding. But Jason, good job, dude. I think you got the base of something really cool there. If you guys want to play this, you can do so here. I feel like the weapon is too accurate and not interesting to shoot. Yeah, that's. I feel like... like the combat system as a whole could use some improvements. Maybe some bigger bullets, maybe some faster bullets, maybe some power-ups that change the bullets, stuff like that. Tim, these feedback Fridays are actually pretty helpful. Well, thank you, man. That's my goal, is to make them helpful. Have the enemies move around. Yes, have different types of enemies, I think. If you get 10 enemies and 10 items, this would be a fun game to play every time. All right, we're playing Greg K's Planet Explorer. Oh, this link didn't work. Greg K, what are you doing to me? Oh, there we go. Never mind. I got it going. I know you're going to move from weekly feedback Fridays. Will you be doing them again in the future whenever you test my game in a month or so? Yeah, we're going to keep doing them. They're just going to decrease in frequency. And partially because we're getting so many submissions now and I can't keep up with them. Partially because we have a lot of people submit like every week and stuff, and I feel like maybe every month would probably be better for that, because then we can fit in more changes and stuff. And then also partially because I need to work on my own stuff a lot. I spend, you know, 4 to 6 hours every week on games constantly is a little complicated to fit in. Gets in the way of some stuff we gotta get done for Game Dev Underground. Oh, this looks awesome. Tim, the link you put in the chat for the last game didn't work. Hold on. This, okay, I'm gonna do this. Dot. I'm removing the dots because the links break up. All right, let's play. It's like little frogs. Fighting lava monsters. I like how half the planet is dark. That's pretty badass. Alright. What did you want feedback on? Let's see. Overall feedback. So the game sounds amazing. The game looks amazing. The combat feels like it feels really good. How do I? This might be a bug or something because I'll restart it. So, this part feels good, like the shooting. I feel like it could use a little bit of screen shake on shoot. Maybe try that, see if that works. But the hitting, like I don't know if he explodes or he stands there and then he just disappears. So I feel like that could use a little bit of polish, like this. You see what I'm saying? Other than that, not much to say, man. Like, if there were like big fire explosions every time I killed somebody with like a satisfying boom, it would be really, really cool. Also, like, I feel like you could lose a little bit of smoothing in the camera. Camera seems a bit jerky. Lurping. Yeah, totally, something like that. When the bullets hit an enemy, it could actually explode instead of boom. Yeah, I would agree with that. Oh, this doesn't hurt me. Oh, it does hurt me. Okay. I also feel like the mouse cursor could probably be like a target or reticle. Like, the creatures look so cool, but just the death is unsatisfying. I feel like the death of the creatures could be more satisfying. Press B for building list. There's stuff you can build. That's not clear in the game at all. Let me try that. Earl, see you later, man. Are these like traps? I don't know what these do, so maybe that's a consideration. So they attack the buildings, that's kind of cool. I don't know what... are they giving me crystals? Is that what they're doing? Like, it would help... it would help knowing what they do. I don't know how you would show that UI-wise, but knowing what each building does would help with the decisions, for sure. The game looks and sounds amazing, dude. I think you need a little bit of tweaking on some of the combat stuff and a little bit of UI stuff, and I think you're good to go. New man, thank you for your subscription. I appreciate it. All right, we're gonna move on. Is there Greg, are you in the chat? Is the developer in the chat? If you are, if you got any specific questions for me, let me know. If I want to make a game with characters of an existing franchise, what should I do? Who should I consult with, Avengers or SpongeBob? Use their characters. You can usually find that information online. One, it's not going to be cheap. Just know that it's going to be... you're going to have to pay them a large upfront money or royalty. Most of the time it's upfront. So just be aware of that. But you can find that information online. I forget what it's called. But there's an actual, like, it's assigned to somebody or some company, and you can contact them. So I want to know what you think about gameplay. I think gameplay is awesome, dude. I like the core gameplay loop. It was really fun. It's great to look at. It feels great. Like I said, the death of the enemies I feel should be more satisfying, but that was like me being nitpicky and, you know. Other than that, like, I think the game's great. Oh, this is a concert game. Perfect. All right. Cyber Escape. All right. Let's do it. I died. Wait, why did that shock me? Hold on. Because of the red thing? Can I control? I can't. I don't understand why it's slowing down. Do I have to climb up like that? It stops right there. This would work way better on mobile. Yeah, probably. Tim's bias for Construct. I am. I love Construct. This game looks great. But even when I click faster, it doesn't... I don't climb all that much. So is there like a sweet spot of like climbing speed? I have to like maintain it basically. Shit. You do climb enough and you don't go down. I'm not going up though. I'm staying in the same spot on the screen. Fallen Frog, thank you for the subscription. Wanted to see the balance and mechanics flaws. Okay. Well, the game looks and sounds great. It does a really good job of giving you the right atmosphere. I feel like there could be a few other different obstacles along the way, not just the electricity. It's a cool game. Is there a way to see my high score? Because I'd really like to see my high score. And I feel like the score font, like, dude, this game looks so amazing. I feel like you should do a custom font for this and use a pixel font because it would really match the art style. This score, now it's too small, but it's also, I think it doesn't really match the game well. Z Raccoon, it's your game. Good job, dude. I fucking love it so far. It looks and sounds fantastic. I think the main problem, yeah, is the score. I think it should just be bigger and it should look better. Maybe a pixel art font. Instead of score, I would say higher or something to make it less gamey. Yeah, you could have distance there or something like that. That's a good suggestion. I like it, dude. Like I said, I feel like it could maybe use one or two extra obstacles, tweak the score a little bit. Once I get the hang of it, I see I gotta kind of keep my speed up, because if I don't, I start to slow down. But I can like do this half jump and save myself, which is nice. We focused on the mechanics, so you got the mechanics down. You got it. Is it possible to make an FPS on mobile? Yes, it is. All right, so we're gonna move on. Do you have any specific questions for me, Raccoon? That's a new, another Google Play game. Alright, we're gonna connect our device again. How the speed feel? The speed felt good. It's kinda like you just gotta keep tapping. Timing it is pretty important. That's why I think, I know you said you're only working on the mechanics, but I think the different obstacles will really help, because you can have ones that are super short that you can kind of get the hang of, and then you can go with the longer ones, because the longer ones are really hard to do stuff with. Disconnect. Hey Tim, how's Philophobia going? It's going good, man. I got a prototype of a new version I'm working on, which I'm really, really excited about. I'm going to push that out to the testers pretty soon. It's completely different than it was before. It's a completely different type of game. I've spent a lot of time trying to make it unique and interesting. And I'd be interested to see what the testers have to say. Am I trying to point this toward the exit? Is that what I'm doing? Okay. Oh shit, this is not showing, is it? Why is it stuck? Hold on. Let me disconnect. There we go. That was weird. You guys didn't get to see the game. What if you could hold to run up walls? That'd be interesting. 7. All right, we'll see if we can get this to show this time. Inflect. So basically, I think the point of this game, John Daniels, thank you for the subscription. I think the point is I hold, and then it turns, and then I got to get it to the exit. That's interesting. It leads to some interesting encounters. So I hold and then it turns and I let go and it goes the direction that I let go in. That's an interesting mechanic. It's a simple looking game, but it's an interesting mechanic. I feel like it could really benefit from sound effects. I'm assuming you just haven't gotten to that yet. Because you pause and you use it to turn at the same time, which is interesting. So you can't just pause infinity. Really like this mechanic? Yeah, I do too. I like it a lot. What do you need feedback on, Adam? Are the mechanics clear enough without text? I think they are. It took me a couple tries to get it, but I think they are. Do you feel like you're in control? I feel like the thing is a little fast, but it has to be, or this game would be too easy. So, yeah, I like that part. Do you feel relaxed while playing, or is there a sense of tension? There's a sense of tension, because he's pretty quick, and the turning is pretty quick. So I don't feel relaxed. As soon as I hit start, I feel a sense of tension. Any general feedback is also welcome. I think sound effects and a slight visual upgrade would go really far with this game. I think it would really, really help. So Like just like a basic, like on here, making, I don't even know, just any kind of visual thing, like rather than, you could just change colors. You don't even have to change the way this is set up. Like if you just find some really good colors, rather than gray on white, if you find some really nice flat colors, I think you can make something really interesting. I like it though. I like it, dude. Tim, you're fat. I'm aware of that, Fotis. If you want to get banned, you can say that again. Appreciate you in the chat though, being nice. Timer is a good tension mechanic too. Yeah, I think it is. I think it works really well because you can't hold on to it forever, which I think is nice. Make the player go underneath the blue block instead of hitting it. Underneath it? That's interesting. Yeah, like go in it. I would agree. That's probably good. That'll be like a good little visual indicator. Well, he does go underneath it a little bit. But like go all the way in. That could be interesting. Yeah, I just think it needs a little visual improvement and some music and some sound, and I think it'll be good. No real feedback on the gameplay, dude. The gameplay's good. The level curve is a little off, because I feel like the circle levels were easier than the square moving levels. Yeah, I think it's good. What a weird reason to threaten a ban. You think it's weird when people come in here negatively and say things? We have a very positive community here. We need to keep it that way. So if people come in and they talk shit, they get banned. That's how we have such a great community. Not that I'm not aware of any of the stuff that's said. It's just that it needs to... What does that contribute to what we're doing? How does that help somebody? How does that give feedback to the game player? Chica, you can't submit your game for this week, but you can submit it for next time if you join our Discord. If you ignored it, then others wouldn't get glory from using. No, yeah, totally. I could have ignored it. But I chose, I'm aware, I didn't get interaction, but I chose to confront him because I've seen him interact in the past, and I want to give him a warning that he just needs to be positive. And it seems like he learned, you know, he's just chilling. All right, so we're going to play Defend the Planet by Paperback Games. Cool. Discord is in the description. How tall are you, Tim? I'm 6'3". I'm a tall dude. I always like villains that turned into heroes. You know, it's weird, right? Because we've had people that come in and talk shit. And then I call them, ow, that hurt my ears. Probably hurt your guys' ears too. I'm turning this down a little bit just in case. But when I call them out and I give them a chance and I say, hey, this is my perspective, like, on whatever, you know, a lot of times people, they'll change. And the ones that don't, they get banned. So I don't think it hurts. Sam, you're awesome. Watching a lot of your videos lately. I think you're providing a ton of help with the game dev community, myself included. Well, thank you, Tasty. I appreciate that. I'm happy to help. Okay, defend the planet. Let's go to instructions first because I... Which number game is this? This is number 13. Like I said, we're going to try and end by 10, which is another hour from now. And then we're going to go watch Pro Indie Dev together. All right, use the arrow keys and left and right to rotate. Use up key to thrust in a direction. Press spacebar to shoot the bullets. Bullets to show the asteroids. Collision of the ship. Asteroid destroys the ship. By any means, if the ship is destroyed, the game is over. Missiles can be brought for shops and exchange of coins. Press X to shoot missile. Okay. X and arrow keys. C to activate purchase shield. Okay. All right, let's play it. Is there a shooting button that I missed? Spacebar. Okay, I was wondering. It's like, oh, wait, I gotta shoot? Alright. Enter your name, please. Jim! My name is Jim. R to restart. There's a typo there. Restart. I love the Atari sounds. Yeah, this gives a retro type of feel. Jim 2. I have the worst score known to man. Oh my god, I'm bad at this game. Jim 3. Okay, I'm gonna try. I have to, so spacebar only shoots one bullet, and I have to keep pressing spacebar. Maybe this is a personal preference, so I'm not sure this is something that you should change, but I feel like you should be able to hold the spacebar and keep shooting. It feels, I don't know, the fact, I don't like keep pressing the space button. It doesn't feel right to me. And I'm not really sure why, but it also gets exhausting in how much you have to shoot in this game. Is there a health pickup? Let's get the health pickup. Oh, damn it. No, can we even... Thank you. Nope. It killed me. The UIs have been intrusive, I would agree with that. So what did you want feedback on? I just want you to play this game. I'd love to hear any kinds of feedback. More details about this game on this page. Played on a small screen, maybe a laptop, 15-inch. Yeah, unfortunately I have a bigger screen, I'm sorry. It's cool. It feels very arcadey. This gets in the way a lot. Like, the game, I think, can remember your name and use it over and over again. The fact that this pops up, especially because you die so often, this pops up over and over again and maybe something that you want to remove. Like, maybe it could show the first time, right? But then, like, after that, like, see, it keeps showing up. It feels solid, though. Like, I feel like it's always my fault when I die. Which is good. I feel like it may actually be safer to just not move at all, though. To be honest, because I'm really bad with the controls. Yeah, not moving is a whole lot safer. I accidentally moved. Oops. Changing the thrust direction is also rough. Camera shake for impact, that's not a bad suggestion. Is there any other... We can go to shop. And we could buy stuff. You don't have enough coins. I have 0 coins. How do I get coins? What's the point of the thing in the middle? That's a good point too. Initially, I thought this was a planet. Well, actually, it is. It is. I can run into it, but I can shoot past it. So I don't know. Creator could add a high score and achievement system. I would suggest different projectiles. There is some kind of high score. I don't know how to see it. Can we go to the high score? Yeah, these are all me. I don't think this is a global high score though. I think you're defending the thing in the middle. Am I? Is that what's going on? I think it is. I think you're right. Okay, so that part's not clear then. That part wasn't clear. Ouch. Cool game though, dude. Yeah, I would say the font probably needs to be changed, but the core gameplay is pretty good. Yeah, the name is Defend the Planet. That wasn't clear in the game, but fucking duh. I'm not good at taking those hints. Like, remember Kill 1,000 Goblins? And I was like, what is the goal? What is the objective with this game again? What do I do? You kill 1,000 goblins. Yeah, here's the link if you guys want to play it. Alright, let's move on. Martin, we're going to play Little Green Arrow. Hope you're ready. Alright, select level. Number one. Wait, what? Giant wasp is your arsenal, and your arrows is your bat.
Unlucky.
You play as Green Arrow, the mightiest bowman in the land. Alright, so... In writing is in their saying, telling them what you're going to say, and then tell them what you just said. What do you mean by that, Pixel? So this game looks fantastic. What did you need feedback on? How to improve for a sequel? Do you based on Game & Watch Donkey Kong 3 game? So I assume I move up and down based on... the arrows? I just avoid the bees? Or do I kill the bees? Okay, so I gotta be completely honest. I don't know what's going on. And I'm not aware of how to play the game. Is there help? Means that you have to repeat the message for people to progress. Yes. Very much so. Anytime you're trying to teach anybody anything, you have to repeat it multiple times. I don't... Wait, can I throw... I can shoot an arrow? So no clear objective. I think you're right, Dylan. I don't know what I'm trying to do. There's this whole thing up here that pushes the bees this way. But then the bees come this way, and then when they get here, they either hit me or I shoot them. Based on the sounds, I'm guessing that they hit me. So, but what, I don't know what this is for. Maybe I'm missing a control. Is there like a space to shoot or something? The right and left mouse buttons both do the same thing. This game feels slow, complex, and boring. I know it's out of nowhere, but does anyone have an idea on how to change your voice to sound like an 8-bit? I don't know, man. I get I probably have to fight him. What the fuck did I do? Wait, okay. Okay, I can kill. Wait, I go here. Alvaro, thank you for your subscription. Okay, wait, so I can shoot arrows. But. Am I trying to kill him? Is that what I'm. Alright, so the game needs to be clearer, and also I think the first level needs to be simpler. Volkiller, thank you for the raid, man. I appreciate it. Welcome, everybody. So I would say. Thank you, man. I appreciate it. Welcome. We're doing a feedback Friday in case everybody's interested. We're giving feedback on indie games. How's everybody doing tonight? Alright, so I would say on this game, the visuals are fantastic. The objective is not clear, and the first level is probably way too hard. Because even though I kind of know my objective and I kind of know that I can shoot now, it took way too long to figure that out, and I think it's way too difficult to plan on all that stuff. So I would work on that stuff, especially if you're thinking about making a sequel. So that's my feedback. If you guys want to play this game, you can do so here. There's the chat in Twitch. And here's the chat in YouTube. So let's move on. Actually, so that we're going to play Snake Maze by Silver Phoenix. Needs a tutorial level to help. I think it could really benefit from a tutorial level. Or some kind of intro sequence, because that was too difficult. I didn't know what I was doing. I didn't know what I was trying to do, and I didn't know how to do it. So. And the game is set up like it's a kid's game, too, so that may not be the best approach. Oh. Okay, let's play it on this screen. Alright. Audio is really loud, let me know if it's too loud for you guys. I fucked myself. Already. Quasi TV, thank you for the follow. Okay. This is interesting. Probably have to go this way, yeah. This is an like a puzzle take on Snake. That's interesting. I like this. This is an interesting take. Yeah, like you can totally do things wrong. I like this. It may get exhausting. Yeah, it's hurting my brain, to be honest. It's like, so what did you need feedback on, dude? General constructive feedback for any aspects of the game. The main piece of feedback I have for this is, when I got myself in a corner like that, it just shows a little escape. I feel like you should make it more clear that it's over, because there's a couple times. Like when I pulled up on that the first time and I went into that corner and I couldn't go anywhere, I saw the escape, but I thought there might still be a way out. So I feel like it should maybe be like game over or restart or something, rather than just escape, to kind of let you know that, yeah, you did fuck up. You got to start over. I really like the concept. I think even though I got that level pretty simply, I feel like you should start with just a simpler level, something that kind of shows the different stuff. I kind of got it. But it was really kind of long for that first experience. So I feel like maybe starting with something like that. And then two, I gotta say, maybe this is a level design thing, but when I was playing through the levels, I kind of feel like, yeah, input funny, maybe some downtime instead of constant puzzles, give the player some time to relax. Like, it was a lot real quick, and sometimes I didn't feel like I solved the puzzle. Sometimes I felt like I accidentally completed the level. And I know I only played like 2 or 3 stages, but yeah, it did, like in my brain, it felt like, whoa, this is really complex and hard. Even though I got through it pretty quickly, I think balancing the puzzles and the stuff, I think is a good suggestion. It's hard to tell which are the switches and which are the blocks if you can't hit. They look pretty similar. I could tell, but I wouldn't be against making them a little more a little more visible. I would agree with that. All right. Baby Bird. Got to play Baby Bird again. Actually, real quick, if you guys are he gave me a direct link. So I'm like, wait, there's a game page. No, it's not published yet. So I won't share with you guys. So we're going to play Baby Bird. Here we go. I remember this game. All right. How to land on a nest. You Timified the game. Godspeed, nest fades in. Too fast, nest fades out. Bad angle. This is great. This is great, dude. Compared to what I did the first time, this is fantastic. This is very visual. This lets me know how to play the game. When I first played the game, I didn't fucking know what was going on. And I would come in at an angle and be like, what the hell is going on? This is great. Like, seriously, if you want to teach someone how to play something at a glance with minimal text, this is how you do it. Alright. I got this, guys. Don't be... Come on now. Just because I failed a lot in the fast doesn't mean I'm going to fail again. I like the yippee. We did it. All right, what did you want feedback on? The new landing aid feature in Visual Aid, how to land on a nest. Yeah, that was great, dude. Cooler, thank you for the follow, man. All right, so let's go here. Land on our nests. I'm not noticing the landing aid feature though, dude, to be honest. So I don't know what you're referring to there. I did it. Oh, I gotta land on both. I gotta land on two nests. Oh, shit. I hit the top. I didn't see the top. Yeah, dude, the graphic that you showed in the beginning was fantastic. You did a great job on that. So if you wanted feedback on that, that was great. When you fly off screen, you come in the other side. Landing aid feature, I didn't get to mess around with that. I didn't find it. Maybe that's something. I mean, I landed easier. I'm assuming that's what that was. So, it helped me land. I'm good with it. All right. All right. Bow, Bob. He says he fixed all the issues that we mentioned before, so we'll play it again and we'll see. Tim is surprised he didn't land on both just like last week. Did I have to land on both last week? What the... My memory is not, you know, like, I don't, things like that just don't stay in my brain. They do not at all. Little details like that. All right, this is the one where you jump to fart.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
And you scream when you die.
Yeah.
Alright, you said hope you can finish the level now. Let's see, we can't spend a ton of time on it though, dude, so because we got our little...
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
I'm a pro. Look at me, I'm a fucking pro.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I can see the ground now. That's a good addition.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
That's gonna keep killing me, I know it is.
Yeah.
I need my extra jump. Oh my god. God damn it. This part does not belong in this level! Okay, quick piece of feedback. I feel like the checkpoint down here should be right up next to the guy. Like, jumping up there is a pain in the ass every time. Like, anything you have to make the player repeat over and over becomes a pain in the ass, I think. There needs to be a checkpoint after this thing. There needs to be a checkpoint after, like, right here should be a checkpoint. And this checkpoint should be down here. That's what I mean, like, making people repeat things over and over again is just, it's not good design. Especially with really hard situations like this. Unfortunately, I gotta move on for time. You made a lot of good improvements, dude. I would say like the little things, like when you have a really hard section of level and you know they're gonna die a lot, making them do mundane tasks before they get back to that place when they restart is a real way to frustrate a player. So anytime you have one of those really hard sections, I would always put a checkpoint right before it so they can keep retrying the hard section over and over again. If they have to do a mundane task and then do the hard section, they're gonna really start to hate that mundane task, if that makes sense. But other than that, I think it's great, dude. Keep on working on it. Go for it. Okay, so we've got Wrath of Rome from Jay.
Actually, I'll pull this off, so. I think it needs more fart variation and more blood. Makes sense. Do you have any questions for me, Mad Props? All right, we've got to spend like only a couple minutes on each one of these games, so because we got to get through this because we're ending at 10, because we're all gonna go watch Pro Indie Dev after this. Wrath of Rome, okay. So Jay, you worked on Polish and giving the same personality. What do you think of the name and logo? Wrath of Rome is a good name. I like the name. The logo looks good. Controls and UI has been improved. It should be easier for you to fully customize your controls now. Keyboard and mouse, that's awesome. Implemented AI difficulties. You can change difficulty player versus AI options. Easier or harder depending on difficulty. Scrap the Spartan character and replace it with Marilla. Alright, so this, okay. AI options. We're gonna go with rookie. We're gonna test out the easy AI. There seems to be some kind of glitch right there. So we're gonna battle.
3, 2, 1.
I forget, man. What were I completely forgot the controls for this game. Jay, are you in the chat? Can you give me the controls? Alright, something, hold on. Something's going on with it. It's lagging a little bit. Rookie. There we go, it's running better now. It was acting weird before.
Three,
Jay.
Two, one.
The graphics look a lot better, dude. They don't like overlap or anything. Oh well, they're starting to go now. Alright, real quick, it doesn't let me escape back to the menu. I assume you just haven't added that yet. Let me go to... It's mouse, right? Okay. Alright. This easy AI is pretty easy. I don't think it's too easy. That other AI was insane. The art will all be replaced? Okay, gotcha. This is a good difficulty. I don't think this is too easy. I'm losing this one. I like the voiceovers and I like the music now too, and the logos looks really cool. You want to know if the easy was too easy. Is veteran playable? There's some kind of glitch, Jay, with the back button not working. It highlights, but I click it and it doesn't go. I've noticed this a couple times now. Player versus AI, AI options. Veteran. Alright, let's try veteran. I'm getting fucked up. Jay, I don't think I'm the guy to tell you whether or not veteran is beatable. I don't think that's gonna be beatable by me. Alright. I may not have put it on veteran, to be honest. Because I went, it went back to the menu. It seems like the stamina bar is going negative for a second. I win. I wasn't a veteran. Maybe I'm just getting better at the game. Player versus AI, warriors, okay. Oh, sweet, dude. All right, Jay, is there any specific questions you have to ask me before we move on? I think your easy AI isn't too easy. I think it's good. Veteran AI, I remember it being harder, but maybe I've just gotten better at the game. I don't know, because I played it a couple times. The polish is great. The new logo, I like the name. I like all that stuff. I like Jay's game too. Alright, this is Eternal Laser. No problem. Jay, if there's anything specific you want to ask, feel free to do so. I know we're on a tight schedule. I hate doing this on a schedule because I really want to take time to dive into each game. But it's good, dude. It's coming along good. Compared to the first time I played it, it's significantly better. Your first published game? Well, congrats. We're going to play it. Interest in general feedback, especially interested if you think I could turn this into something actually published to public. Crucially, I'd like to know if you found this game entertaining. Do you play adding RPG elements or resource shops in this game could work? Alright, let's see. Alright, I'm clicking start. Okay. You got wrecked. Okay. The buttons don't seem to work well. Let me see if I can change the resolution. Maybe that'll help. So they're weird. Like, they're not... I think I got to click that to click by clicking in random spots. All right. There we go. Just wrong resolution. Okay. One hit kills are brutal. I like how the AI flies in, though. Okay, so one thing I'll tell you right up front. It would really be nice, because I like the game, I want to play the game again. It'd be really nice to just hit a key and retry. I have to click main menu and I have to click start again. If there was just like a space to retry button, that'd be great. This looks great, dude. This is really cool. When you kill an enemy, some explosions would be really cool. Make me feel really good about being a badass. The music and the menu are great. The logo's great. I'd really love to see some alien explosions from me fucking them up. Same on the player character, too. When I get hit, should be like boom. You feel like RPG elements and resource drops in the game? I don't know what you mean by RPG elements, but power-ups and stuff would definitely work in this game. Like if I could get like a triple shot or like a tracking bullets, stuff like that, that'd be really fun to play. I'd totally play that. The star system looks pretty cool, too. You think it's weird? I think it looks cool. It's like I'm going towards it. It needs explosions and screen shake. I agree. Explosions and screen shake and a tap to restart, I think, are the main things. Those would be my main piece of feedback. The music and the presentation look great, dude. The art looks great. Do you have any specific questions for me? If you guys want to play it, Kasari, do you want me to share the link or not really? Do you mind if I share a link? So other people can play it. pretty bog standard currently. You got a good basis to start at, dude. Could be a pretty cool game. This is the first time I've gotten a .blend file. Let's play this. I haven't played a Blender game ever on the channel. WASD to move. Dylan, see you later, man. Spacebar to jump, collect the coins. Cool. You guys encourage me to work on it more and not throw it in the bin? No, dude, it's good. You should work on it more. Sub button. You can't touch red objects. I did touch red objects. What do you mean I can't touch it? Buttons help you get around. Okay. Alright, what did you want feedback on? Gameplay and graphics. Gameplay is pretty cool. The camera view makes it a little hard to play the game. The perspective is a little weird. I feel like maybe a third person perspective might be cool for this. Like, it's making it really hard to get this coin because the perspective is a little weird. Good night. I post the timestamps again tomorrow if you haven't kept track of them, Tim. Jay, if you could do that, you would be a beast. Thank you so much for that. Yeah, that's one thing I got to do better. Yeah, so the camera is a little difficult. The gameplay is good. The camera is a little difficult. The graphics are basic, but I don't think they look bad. I think, was that the whole game? So I could skin this, or... It's a cool start to a game, for sure. I feel like you could use a couple, like, game feel effects. Like, you could make the cube stretch when he jumps and stuff like that. The blank floor doesn't help with perspective. That's a good observation. So I would maybe look into the camera a little bit. I think that's your main obstacle right now. What you liked, you wanted gameplay and graphics. Your gameplay is good. Your graphics could maybe use a little bit of work. If you have any specific questions, let me know, though. All right, Excalibur, or this is a game called Parum. Parum. If you guys want to play this the game I just played, you could do so here. All right, so Parum, let's play Parum. A grid on the floor, I think, would be a good addition. I agree with that. Alright, you wanted feedback on difficulty, intuitiveness, play, and overall experience. Okay, so mouse is aim and swing, WSD to move. Okay. It's pretty intuitive so far. There's coins. This is cool, dude. I don't know why I need coins, but I'm all about the coins. The circles are a little weird to move out of corners. I thought that was an enemy. I did not know that was a checkpoint. Bring me 6 coins. Pickaxe range increase. Okay, so range, so I could do this. That worked. Could I also get this one? Yeah. This is cool, dude. It's definitely intuitive. It uses WSD and mouse. It's pretty intuitive. Overall experience is pretty good so far. I don't exactly know what my end goal is. Like, it didn't give me like a survive or like a get to the end or collect 25 coins. So I'm not 100% sure what I'm supposed to be doing, but as far as like how to play the game, I'm pretty sure I have a good understanding of that. Overall experience is pretty good, man. This is a cool little animation. I really like your art. I like your atmosphere. You have a cool little atmosphere going. You're a starving dwarf, find a snack. What does the main page say? Losing battle with poverty and they're starving. Okay. So the goal is just to go around and find snacks. It's made for the Game Maker 48 jam. Cool, dude. This is really cool. If you guys want to play this, I like it. I like the experience. You can play it here. Here's a link. Yeah, as far as difficulty, I don't think it was too difficult. Intuitive play was definitely intuitive. Overall experience, I would say, is positive. Alright, so let's play Space Something. Let's do it. Get the treasure in the end to buy snacks. Could be one of those games where you make your own goal and explore about the game. It felt like you should explore, but I also felt like I was surviving, which is cool. I really like the atmosphere. The music and the sound effects and all that really, really, really help. The links, I don't know what the problem is with links. Every time I post it on YouTube, it breaks the links. And I don't know why. I don't know why. It's something I gotta figure out. But it's excalibur2.itch.io/param. Or you can search it on itch. P-A-R-U-M. Yeah, Joseph, good job. You're the developer. Move forward with W key. Aim using mouse cursor. Left with mouse button. Oh, fire with left mouse button. Holding right. Okay. Experimental weapons for space. Oh shit. You motherfuckers. Get off my ship. Alright. The bullets in this are super tiny. It makes it really, really hard to aim. Also, the difficulty is a little high. On combat field, it's just a prototype. Okay, so combat, okay. I'll tell you what the combat issue is here. This game looks cool. The combat's, I feel like the sound is part of the combat problem, because it's not a satisfying hit sound. And also the bullets are really, really tiny. They're really, really tiny. I think they could be a lot bigger. Because of like how far a distance you have to shoot stuff sometimes, I feel like the bullets should be bigger. I also, again, this is one of those things that maybe just be personal preference, but I don't like clicking every time I have to shoot unless it's something big or massive, like a missile or something. Clicking over and over and over again is making my finger hurt. I don't think the bullets are too tiny. I think the enemies are too tiny. Yeah, it could be the enemies too. I would actually make them both bigger. They're really hard to shoot. The game looks great, and it's like it wants to be played. I could tell. It's one of those games that I could totally spend time on. Just clicking every time for a tiny little underwhelming bullet that's probably not going to hit everybody, I think, is a little frustrating. I think the bullets and the enemies could be bigger, personally. And I think an auto shoot would be nice. What do you guys think? Could you add some atmosphere effect between the foreground and the planet? That's a good... The movement feels a little... as far as I know, I can't move side to side, right? So, like, only moving forward and aiming with the mouse feels... I don't know, it's different. I'm used to moving with WASD and aiming with the mouse. Like, moving, like, almost like twin stick. But that might be part of it, too. Feels like something hitting my window in the hail. Yeah, the sound could definitely improve. The gun feels tiny because of that sound. It feels like a tap, tap, tap. Like a heavy, bassy machine gun sound. Like, poof, 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 poof. Boom, bing, boom. You know, that kind of thing when it hits. I think that would really... If Comtar is in the chat, let me know. All right, we're going to play Fred. Flamber said for no one to take his advice because it might be bad. I would agree with that. I think everybody's advice can be bad. Comtar, do you have any specific questions for me, man? If you don't take his advice, you're taking his advice. We're not taking his advice. WC and mouse down to go through doors. Escape to pause, okay. This is cool. What did you need feedback on? How does the game feel to play? Is the core mechanic fun? What frustrates you while playing? What is the core mechanic? Just movement and mouse. I can't jump on their heads. Oh, I get a little drone that shoots everybody for me. That's cool. My little drone comes with me. So do I need to jump on my drone? Oh, my mouse is the drone. With the camera, that makes it really weird. Oh, that's cool. So I can like have my drone go shoot the stuff. Like this to go in this door. I didn't notice that at first. Okay. Stay away from my boy. That's a cool mechanic. It's very different than games I've played. I gotta do like the whole navigation thing. That's really cool. It's kind of hard to plan my movements. Look at the mouse and WASD, but I got two drones. Aw, shit, son. Shit's going down. That's cool. I like that. So yeah, dude, I don't have much to add. I think, I mean, obviously you could use music and all that stuff for polish, but I don't think that I think the core mechanic's fun. It's the camera frustrated me a little bit because the camera moves, and because the camera moves, my mouse is now in a different position. So that was a little frustrating. But I don't think that's bad. I think you got to work that out. You got to figure that out. But I don't. I like what you're onto there. I think it's a good, interesting little thing. All right, guys. If you want to play this game, you can do so here. Cool. And then. Last game on our list is Entropy 2120. Let's find out the next one. All right, so he wants feedback on the gameplay. I like the music. I feel like Terminator is about to come in. Is it loading? If this is loading, you need some kind of indication here. Like, it'll just help if that said loading or something. Oh, shit. Not what I was expecting. Oh. Holy shit. Lazarus. Steal data about a project. I like this so far. Where's my mission? I like how the music blew me away just as much as a surprise. Yeah, the music's on point. I feel like the game is still... This is super fast-paced. I like this. I like this. I'm gonna play some more of this. The motion blur is a little weird, and I feel like I die really, really easily. Aim for the head and use cover? Okay. I got you. I don't know if the motion blur... Is that a feature? I really like this a lot. How do I get out of here? The fucking boxes. I don't know if my frame rate's dropping or what's going on. Is there a way to have... I don't know. I wish I could show the frame rate because, like here, it's definitely above 60 FPS. But I feel like, yeah, like down here, I don't know if it drops or what. Yeah, it's dropping. It drops a lot. I don't know why that is. It dropped a ton. You got inventory? You got everything? It's pretty sweet, dude. This is fucking sweet. Your gameplay is rock solid. Like I said, I think there's a frame issue. But I don't have much to add on the gameplay, man. The gameplay rocks. I don't have much feedback. Is there any specific questions you have for me? Anything at all? I think it's great, dude. Bad frame rate will kill a fast-paced shooter, so you need to optimize it. I agree with that. So it's something that you gotta probably like really think about. All right, so here's what we're going to do. Guys, if you're on YouTube with me, I highly recommend right now that you move over to Twitch. Go to twitch.tv/TimRuswick because all of us are going to move into the Pro Indie Dev Room and we're going to watch the conference for the next 3 hours. There's some really cool people speaking today. It's a completely free conference hosted by Starlight Skies. And I highly recommend that you move to Twitch with us. I'm going to put a link into my channel so you guys can see. So you guys can, hopefully this will work. YouTube links never work. But I'm going to say dot instead of the dots. I highly recommend you move over to Twitch because we're gonna host that. If you're on YouTube and you're not moving to Twitch... thank you for having such a fantastic, awesome stream. Thank you for hanging out. I appreciate you all you guys watching. Scrubs, thank you for the follow on Twitch. I appreciate you. We're gonna move in there. We're gonna do credits real quick and then we're gonna host Starlight because we're gonna watch. But thank you guys, everybody. If you're on Twitch, we're gonna go watch Pro Indie Dev. If you're on YouTube, have a good night and have a lovely night. Sleep peeps. Alright. Get the one.
Get the party.